Welcome to Grab and Go Info. LASSO is also called L1 regularization, and Ridge is also called L2 regularization. Elastic net is the combination of LASSO and Ridge. All three are techniques commonly used in machine learning to correct overfitting. In this tutorial, we will cover what's the difference between LASSO, Ridge, and Elastic net, how to run LASSO for classification model using Python, how to run Ridge for classification model using Python, how to run ElasticNet for classification model, how to compare the performance of LASSO, Ridge, and ElasticNet. Let's get started. In step 0, we will talk about the differences between LASSO, Ridge, and ElasticNet. LASSO and Ridge regularization correct overfitting by shrinking the coefficient of the model. During the model training process, instead of minimizing the model training error, they minimize the model training error plus a penalty term. LASSO and Ridge have different calculation algorithms for the penalty term. ElasticNet's penalty term is a combination of the algorithm from LASSO and Ridge. The penalty term has a parameter called lambda. It controls the strength of the penalty. When lambda equals 0, the penalty term equals 0. So the model is a model with no regularization. When lambda increases, the penalty term value increases and the model coefficients values decrease. When lambda goes infinity, the model coefficients shrink to nearly 0. The model is left with only the intercept, which predicts the average value for every data point. LASSO's penalty term is the penalty parameter lambda multiplied by the sum of the absolute value of the coefficient. Because LASSO's coefficients may shrink to zeros, it can be used for automatic feature selection. Ridge shrinks the model coefficients based on the sum of the squared coefficients. Ridge does not shrink the model coefficients to zero. ElasticNet's penalty term is a combination of LASSO and Ridge regression's penalty term. It sets some coefficients to zeros, but the number of the coefficients set to zero is smaller than LASSO. In the first step, let's import the Python libraries needed for this tutorial. We will use the breast cancer dataset for this tutorial. So datasets from sklearn needs to be imported. Pandas and NumPy are imported for data processing. Matplotlib is for visualization. And standard scaler is for data standardization. For model training, we imported train test split and logistic regression. For model performance evaluation, we imported plot confusion matrix, classification report, log loss, rock curve, and rock awk score. In the second step, the breast cancer data from sklearn library is loaded and transformed into a pandas data frame. The information summary shows that the dataset has 569 records and 31 columns. The target variable distribution shows 63% of ones and 37% of zeros in the dataset. Therefore, 1 means the patient has breast cancer, and 0 represents the patient does not have breast cancer. In step 3, we split the dataset into 80% training and 20% testing dataset. Random state makes the random split results reproducible. The training dataset has 455 records, and the testing dataset has 114 records. Standardization is to rescale the features to the same scale. It is calculated by extracting the mean and divided by the standard deviation. After standardization, each feature has zero mean and unit standard deviation. Standardization should be fit on the training dataset only to prevent test dataset information from leaking into the training process. Then, the test dataset is standardized using the fitting results from the training dataset. There are different types of scalers. Standard scaler and min-max scaler are most commonly used. For a dataset with outliers, we can use robust scaler. In this tutorial, we will use standard scaler. We can see that after using standard scaler, all the features have zero mean and unit standard deviation. Let's get the summary statistics for the training data before standardization as well. And we can see that the mean and standard deviation can be very different in scale. For example, the area error has a mean value of 40 and a standard deviation of 47. On the other hand, the compactness error has a mean of about 0.023 and a standard deviation of 0.019. In step 5, We will create a logistic regression with no regularization as the baseline model. Logistic regression in sklearn uses ridge regularization by default. When checking the default hyperparameter values of the logistic regression, we see that penalty equals L2, meaning that L2 regularization is used. We need to change the penalty from L2 to none to get the model with no regularization. After running the baseline logistic regression model, we also predicted the testing dataset using predict and calculated the predicted probabilities using predict proba. After getting the predicted value and predicted probability, we are ready to check the model performance. First, let's check the rock curve. We got the area under curve value of 0.9818. The log loss value for the model is 2.02. The confusion matrix shows 1 false positives and 6 false negatives. A total of 7 incorrect predictions correspond to an accuracy of 0.939. We do not want to miss any actual cancer patient for the breast cancer prediction and do not mind having a few false positives. So recall would be the metric to pay most attention to. The recall is the true positive rate. It measures the percentage of actual cancer patients captured by the model. We can see that the logistic regression gave us the recall value of 0.915, meaning that 91.5% of the actual cancer patients are captured. Next, let's check the coefficients of the model. Based on their absolute values, I rank the model coefficients from high to low, and we can see the top variables have coefficients in a few hundred. In step 6, LASSO model is used to run the same analysis. Penalty equals L1 means LASSO regularization is applied. Solver is an algorithm to use in the optimization problem. There are different types of solvers. For small datasets, Liblinear is a good choice, whereas SAG and SAGA are faster for large datasets. The ROC value is 0.9967 for LASSO, higher than the logistic regression value of 0.9818. The log loss decreased from baseline logistic regressions 2.015 to 0.0685. That's a significant improvement. The confusion matrix shows the same false positive count of 1, but the false negative count decreased from 6 to 2. Because of the decrease in false negative count, the accuracy increased from 0.939 to 0.974. And the recall value increased from 0.915 to 0.972. LASSO's coefficients decreased a lot compared to the logistic regression coefficients. As a result, about half of the features have a coefficient of 0. So LASSO gives us a simpler model with better performance. If you find the information helpful so far, please like the video and subscribe to the channel. In step 7, we will run ridge regression by changing the penalty to L2. The ROC value is 0.9974, which is slightly higher than 0.9967 for LASSO. The log loss decreased from LASSO regressions 0.0685 to 0.0601. That's an improvement too. The confusion matrix shows the same false positive count of 2 and the false negative count of 1. Although the total number of incorrect predictions is 3. The same as LASSO regression, ridge regression has better performance because the false negative decreased by 1. Because the number of incorrect predictions is the same between LASSO and ridge, the accuracy is the same at 0.974. Because the false negative count decreased from 2 to 1, the recall value increased from 0.972 to 0.986. Ridge's coefficients decreased slightly compared to the LASSO regression coefficients. Some of the features have a coefficient close to 0, but none of them equals 0. Based on the performance comparison, we can see that Ridge has slightly better performance than LASSO, but LASSO has a simpler model than Ridge. In step 8, we will run elastic net regression by changing the penalty to elastic net. Loan ratio equals 0.5 means that the elastic net uses 50% LASSO and 50% ridge. The ROC value for the elastic net is 0.9974, which is about the same as the ridge regression. The log loss decreased from ridge regression 0.0601 to 0.0597. That's a slight improvement. The confusion matrix shows the same false negative count of 1, and the false positive count decreased from 2 to 1. Because the number of incorrect predictions decreased compared to LASSO and Ridge, the accuracy increased from 0.974 to 0.982. The recall value is the same at 0.986. Ridge's coefficients were set to zeros for some features, but the number of features with zero coefficient is smaller than LASSO. In this tutorial, we covered what's the difference between LASSO, Ridge, and Elastic Net, how to run LASSO for the classification model, how to run Ridge for classification model, how to run Elastic Net for classification model, how to compare the performance of LASSO, Ridge, and Elastic Net. We can see that regularization improved the model performance significantly than not using regularization. Elastic Net has the best performance among the three regularization algorithms, followed by Ridge and LASSO regression. However, this may not be true for all the datasets. Therefore, I suggest trying all three algorithms for your project, doing hyperparameter tuning, and choosing the algorithm that works best for your dataset. If you found the information in this tutorial helpful, please click the like button and subscribe to the channel. I publish tutorials on machine learning, deep learning, and big data processing every week. If you prefer the written version of the tutorial, please go to grabandgoinfo.com. I will put the link in the video description. This is the blog post for this tutorial. It has all the code and explanations in the video. Thank you for watching. See you in the next video.